Hello guys, welcome to the new section. In this section we are going to see how we can create the 3D objects. Okay, up to the previous section we have seen how we can create the 2D sketches. Now in this new section we are going to see how we can convert those 2D sketches into a 3D one. Okay, for that open the create parametric as usual. Here the three basic planes are visible. Now in today's section I'm going to choose the front plane. So whatever you wish or whatever the dimensions being taken, you choose the planes accordingly. Now I will choose the front plane and sketch over it. Click the front plane and select the sketch icon. Now the references have been created. Now in order to create the sketches, switch to the sketch view. Once you have done so, we need to draw the basic 2D diagram. We need to draw any basic sketches. For that, I'm going to choose the rectangle now. Okay, choose the rectangle. Here, the by default corner rectangle is being selected. Select it and draw some random rectangles. Click escape. If you want to modify the dimensions, we can modify it. Select the base as 150. And select the height as 75, just a wish. Zoom through it. Okay, now this is the basic rectangle which you have created. Now this is the 2D. Now we are going to convert it as a 3D by using the extrusion option. Basically extrude is like a pulling up. It's like pulling up over the under the perpendicular axis. Now in this case, for the x direction and the y direction have been initiated, but there is no values in the z direction, so we are going to pull up over the z direction. Okay, we can remember it by that sense. Okay, click OK. Now the model menu has been by default came. Click the extrude option. Okay, now it's been the entire object is being displayed in the orange color in order to give a sense to the user. It is still in the editing phase. Okay, it's not a final one. Yeah, in order to visualize the third dimension, click the mouse middle button, just the scroll wheel. Click the scroll wheel and move the mouse in order to roll over the object. It is called as the roll option. Click the middle mouse scroll button and then rotate the mouse. See, this is the basic rolling option. Here we can visualize that the height has been 50.49 and still it is not the final one. We can modify it. We can modify it by clicking the circle over here. By hovering up and down, we can vary. Or if we know the dimension already, we can enter that dimension over the text box here. For this case, I'm going to give 50 and click enter. Once you press enter, it's been modified to 50. Okay, now still it is in the editing phase. If you click OK, the color will change. See, it's been changed from the orange color to the default color. This is default gray color. Okay, this is the basic extrude operation where we have created a cuboid, right? Now in order to make more interesting, we will draw a staircase structure. This is a staircase like structure. This is a rectangle. If we can draw another smaller rectangle over it, it may give a sense as a staircase. Okay, for that case, please select the top surface of the cuboid. Now see that the top surface has been highlighted in the green color. In this case, we can use this surface of the cuboid itself as a plane where we can draw another new sketches over it. Okay, once we have selected the necessary surface, click on the sketch option. Okay, see, references has been created, and move on to the sketch view. Now the top surface of the rectangle itself has become as a plane where we can draw the sketches. Okay, now in order to make things easier and smoother, we can introduce some references. Click the reference here. The reference icon is there. Click the reference icon and select the edges wherever you want to apply the references. Now I need the reference over this edge and over this edge. Since these two edges have already been referenced, no need to create another new reference. Okay, once you have been created, see, four references has been created by us, two by default and two by our wish. Click OK. Now I am going to introduce a rectangle or create a rectangle over this surface, over this area. So again, click the corner rectangle, select this corner and some default length, click escape. It is being accurately being monitored and accurately being created over the midpoint of the rectangle. Okay, so because of that only we are not getting the dimensions. We can't change the dimensions because the rectangle itself has been modified to the middle pin, right? Click OK, and as usual, select the extrude option. Now see, another staircase like structure has been created. Give the height as some 35. Okay, click static mark. Now see, we have created some staircase like structure. If we wish to introduce a triangle over this or the back side, we can also do so. We can also do like that. In order to make that, select the back surface of the rectangle, click the sketch icon, switch over the sketch view. Now we need to introduce the reference. If you see, two rectangles have been created. So you see here, click this edge and also click this edge. If you want to introduce the rectangle from the bottom surface itself, you can select the surface 6 reference, but I don't need so. So we can neglect this one, or if you wish you can click, but it will be of no use. Click close and then pan over the surface. For panning, as I told earlier, click the switch, click the shift icon and simultaneously press the middle scroll button and then move over it so that you can pan. For rolling, you don't need to press the shift, just by pressing the middle scroll button of the mouse itself and you can roll the object. Okay, now we can create the triangle. For that, line itself is enough. First draw the base of the triangle and then to the click over it and then complete it. Press escape. In order to verify whether it's a closed surface, press the middle button of the mouse. See, it's been created. Now, as we all know, a perfect triangle or the equilateral triangle will have the angles equal. So it is so you enter 45 degrees over here. This makes the triangle as an equilateral or a perfect one. Okay, you can also vary this one to your wish. For example, give 75 like that. Now it makes the perfect triangle. Okay, this I think this one makes the equilateral triangle. Okay, similarly you can vary the dimension for any of the figures. Okay, once you have finished with it, click OK, roll over it, click the extrude option. You see, it's being created away from the object, but I need over this direction, the opposite direction. In order to make it, click this arrow mark. If you click this arrow mark, the direction will be reversed. Okay, see, now it's been reversed, but I don't need these extra spaces. I need within this top rectangle, so you just drag it. This makes sense. Okay, but if you need up to this one, you can drag and drop. Okay, right, like this you can draw. Or if you need to create a new object, for example, let this distance be 25, okay. I need the extrusion in the opposite direction also for the same distance. For that, I can equally vary that one by click that option. Here, the second one is the extrude on both surfaces, both sides with the equal one. So click that one. Now we can see that the 25 has been split up equally between these two surfaces. If you enter this as a 50, from the central plane towards the left, it's being 25, and from the central plane towards the right, it's being 25. Like this also you can vary. Okay, if you click the third one, that is the extrude up to the next surface, you can see that nothing is being created, because in the x direction only the triangle is being displayed. There's none of the other surfaces available over this surface, so there's no surface for the software to identify and to extrude the triangle up to that one. So that's why it's not creating anything. If we have created the triangle over this section, it would have been extruded up to the top cuboid, because in this direction cuboid is being present. So the software automatically recognizes that one and extrudes that up to the suitable distance. Okay, since in this case we are not having the surfaces for the third layer, it is not being created. So for us, the first one, that is the distance up to which we can choose, we can give it as the 35, for example. Click OK. See, we created something like a temple, like that, or a chair or a sofa, right? We can create like this. This is the basic extruding option. We can create anything using this extrude. Okay, implement your creativity and create n number of objects, n number of parts, right? This brings the end of the session. We'll be discussing the available options, other options, in the next upcoming one. Okay, happy learning, have a great day.